गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः सच्चिदानन्दरूपाय विश्वोत्पत्यादि हेतवे तापत्रय विनाशाय श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः श्रीकृष्णाय वयं नमः ओम योऽन्तः प्रविश्य मम वाचमिमां प्रसुप्तां संजीवयत्यखिल शक्तिधरस्वधाम्नाम् अन्याश्च हस्तचरण श्रवणत्वगादीन् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यं प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यं प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यं We are in Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 27, and today we have to begin from verse 30. And we are looking at the yoga of formal worship, Kriya Yoga, and here the Lord has showed how through this, as long as we are considering ourselves to be the body, only at the body level kriya happens at body level, speech level and mind level. Kriya means where there is activity, so we do activity at the body level, we do activity at the speech level, and there is activity of thoughts at the mind level. So how do we employ these so that we are qualified to be called a human being? Otherwise, if we do not control our mind, if we are not abiding in the divine, then we are worse than an animal. Liberation is possible only through the human birth. So this, after explaining all this, why suddenly formal worship? Because majority of the people are lost in the body level only. So they need to practice, they need to bring their senses, their energies, their speech, their thoughts, they're under control. They need to be disciplined. And what better way than, your Bhagwan has given one of the ways. And ways by which we can purify ourselves. And purification of what? Purification of the bonds of karma. And that is the prarabdha karma, the sanchit prarabdha and agami karma. So we have to, and as long as they are there, till then we will continue to be reborn. Then mergence in the divine is not possible. Recognition of the self is not possible. So here the question that Uddhavji asked was, how do we, please give us a way forward by which we can be free of this, bonds of karma, and the karma bandha vimochanam. एतत् कमलपत्राक्ष कर्म बंध विमोचनम भक्ताय चानुरक्ताय ब्रूहि विश्वेश्वरेश्वर. सो कर्म बंध विमोचनम, हाउ डू वी डिसॉल्व अवर कर्म बंध बॉन्डेज ऑफ एक्शन, हाउ डू वी एंड एक्शन सी हाउ डू यू डिसॉल्व कर्म. टू डिसॉल्व कर्म यू हैव टू डिसॉल्व द कर्ता. कर्ता मीन्स द डूअर. Because the karta is identified with activity, therefore he has become karta. Therefore he has this sprout of desires one after the other. I want to do this, I want to achieve this, I want to gain this, I have to travel here, I have to do sadhana, I have to attain moksha, etc., etc., etc. So what is the way that he, as a karta, because only a karta can do karma, he thinks that he is doing the karma. Actually speaking, karma is not done by anyone. Activity is happening. Where is activity happening? It is happening at the body level. Body, breath, mind, intellect. And what is the karta? Karta's original nature. The karta's original nature, the karta bhokta, the doer and enjoyer, what is his original nature? That of consciousness. He is the sakshi. And because he has got identified with this body, therefore he has become the karta and bhokta. Therefore he feels that he has to perform actions. He has guilt about the past actions. And he continues to entertain desires of the future, to achieve this or achieve that. See? And all this, even though he listens to satsang, but still he continues in that loop, collecting agami karma, means collecting more impressions. Sanchit karma and agami karma. Sanchit karma is accumulated impressions. Prarabdha karma is those impressions which have manifested as this life, those seeds within our subconscious which have manifested at this life. And agami karma, all those impressions or seeds which you are still going to collect if you don't live correctly with awareness. So, what is the way out? Move from tamasic karma. We cannot straight away, just like that, we cannot give up the karta bhav. So, what is this karta told? The karta is told, you move from gross worship to subtle worship to transcendental worship. Or he is told, you move from tamasic disposition activity to rajasic activity to sattvic activity. See, many people understand all this. When they come to satsangs, they understand. But the problem is they are still identified with their body. And whether you do this puja, or whether our understanding is that if you are performing action in your daily life, that is also Kriya Yoga only. Are you performing from morning, the moment you wake up till you go to sleep, activity is happening at your body level. What activity is going on? Is it about backbiting? Is it about manipulating? Is it about artha and kama? Meaning money and desires? Is it about how to improve the world? Or is it about God realization? The thoughts we are meaning here. See? So activity is going on in the body level. we are understanding also that activity happens at the body level, not at the conscious level. But then we find ourselves to be attached with the activity. Okay, now you have a choice. And the choice is, one of the choices given here is that you practice this yoga or formal worship. By doing this, what will happen? You will learn to do something for no reason. Majority people in their families, they do pujas to get some result. But we have to do puja for no reason. Then why do we do it? Because it's the right thing to do. Why we are invoking the Lord? Just because we want to remember Him. We have got nothing to do. We are passing our time on this earth. Do it for that purpose. See how quickly you will get purified of the karma bandha. See, the issue with our worship is that there is a hook of desire, of a result, of something in return, which corrupts the whole process. So whether you do puja, or you are doing puja of your husband, or you are doing puja of your wife, or you are doing puja of your family by serving it, or you are doing puja of the food by cooking it and making it nice, don't do it with an intention of a particular result. Do it just because it's the right thing to do. If nothing, offer it to the Lord. Why? For no reason. Life has put this body in the kitchen, or at this moment it has put this body in front of you. It has to speak. But is it speaking because this person has to improve the world? Is this person going to, this body going to feel bad for some reason the satsang doesn't happen? See? No. So then, if this body has to perform, then how do we perform? We perform as an offering to the divine. That's what the invocation mantra was. Om yonta pravishya mama vacham imam prasuptam sanjeevayatya khila shakti dharaswadham nam. See? So don't take ownership. Let actions happen. You can never, as long as you are alive, you can never live without performing actions. Now, those without performing actions or without performing activity. But understand, the activity or actions are happening at the body level. And every moment, something invokes the activity out of this equipment. See, so here the 16 step puja was told, and the various steps of first the purification of remembering the Lord, inviting the Lord, giving Him an asana, then the sankalpa, then the shuddhikaran of the body, different parts of the body, then the different gods were invoked, then different devatas were invoked, different directions were invoked. Basically, the 16th step puja goes asanam samarpayami, avahanam samarpayami, asanam samarpayami, what did I say? Dhyanam samarpayami. First is dhyanam. Second is avahanam. Third is asanam. Fourth is achamaniyam. Achamaniyam? Fifth is Arghyam. Sixth is padehopadyam, washing his feet, or the other way around, whichever way. Then sixth is snanam, then panchamrita snanam, and then again snanam, all comes in one. Then giving him clothes to wear and ornaments to wear, vastram, upavitam, and then abharanani. Abharanani means all the ornaments, and after that haldi, haridra, kumkumam, chandanam samarpayami. After that akshata samarpayami. After that pushpam samarpayami. After that dhupam samarpayami, deepam samarpayami. Then comes the naivedyam, and after that comes the karpurarti. These are the 16 steps. I don't know, did I add extra or but in all it is 16 steps. So that's in short. Now here we left at verse 29, and in verse 29 it was told he should worship by offering them water to wash their hands and so on. Goddess Durga, Vinayaka, the sage Vyasa, the Vishvaksena, all these four as surrounding the Lord in four corners, intervening the four quarters. His own preceptor, Guru Maharaj, as standing to his left, and the gods, the eight guardians of the spheres, each in his relative position according to the direction in which their spheres are located. And of course, facing the Lord, not facing away from the Lord. So, till here we had done. Many of you are already doing puja at home, so it shouldn't be. In this, few extra steps are given, this particular one and the previous. Now let's read from 30th to 35th verse. Chandano shira karpura kumkuma guru vasitaihi salilai snapayen mantraihi nityada vibhave sati swarna dharmanuvakena mahapurusha vidyaya paurusheyanapi suktena ma samabhi rajanadibhi vastropavita bharana patrasragandha lepanaihi alankurvita saprema madbhakto mam yathochitam padyamachamaniyam cha gandham sumanasokshatan dhupadipopaharyani dadhyanme shraddhayarchakah gudapayasa sarpishi shashkulyapupamodakan sanyavadadhi supanchcha naivedyam sati kalpayet abhangon mardanadarsha dantadhavabhishechanam annadya gita nrutyadi parvani shurutanvaham. So in the 30th verse he says, Chandana Shira Karpura Kumkuma Guru Vasitaihi Salila Isnapayan Mantraihi Nityada Vibhave Sati. The seeker or the puja, the one who is doing the puja, should, if there is sufficient wealth, daily bath me. Bhagwan is saying, na? So daily bathe me with water fragrant by sandal paste. Ushira, a kind of aromatic grass, camphor, saffron and aloe wood, chanting all the while the sacred texts such as Suvarna Dharmanuvaka or Rig Veda, commencing with the words Suvarna Dharmam, etc. The Mahapurusha Vidya, a sacred text sacred to Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Person, the Purusha Sukta, and the sacred texts of Sama Veda such as Rajana Sama and Ruhina Sama. So normally we chant only Purusha Suktam, we chant normally. And then in the 32nd verse he says, 31st also was done. 32nd says, Vastropavita Bharana Patrasragandhalepanaihi Alankurvita Saprema Madbhakto Mam Yathochitam. In the 32nd, he says, my devotee should also lovingly set me in the proper way with rainbow, means the clothes and the jewels, the sacred thread. Rema is the clothes, then the sacred thread, that is the janeu, then the jewels, the flowers, the wreath, the pushpamala, and of basil leaves, scent, and sandalwood paste. You want to see this puja with how much devotion. It's like a meditation if it is done properly. You go to Badrinath, and if you can sit, I had two times I had the chance to sit in front of the Lord in that small place and watch the puja taking place early in the morning, 5:30, 4:30, 5:30, and at that time the priest there, who is a Nambudri from Kerala, he decorates that huge Shaligram Vigraha of Badrinarayan. And literally, he dances through it. All the priests there are chanting the Vedas at the top of their voice. It's so beautiful. It's all reverberating. And the priest, systematic, he has done it for many years, but the reason it looks beautiful and meditative is because of the priest's devotion with which he is dressing up the Lord. And in the end, it's such a beautiful vigraha, with all the way he places the flowers. He's not just throwing the flowers or just putting the clothes because he has to put. He's so careful. And not only, I'm just telling you, Badrinath, but there are many other places where they do the same. And it is not up to the deity. It's up that beauty, that meditative poise that comes about as a result of this active action shows the purity of the pujari. If you are enjoying your puja, vigraha is the same. It is your disposition. It is your dedication, your surrender, your joy, which is expressing there while doing the puja. And when we do it to a stone, or we do it to a stone Shivalinga, or we do it to a photograph, and we are able to invoke that joy within us, even though we have to do it on a daily basis if we are doing the puja. You are running your family also on a daily basis. Do you do it out of the joy, or do you do it out of frustration? See? So we learn by interacting with the Lord. At least in the puja, we learn that, because that is also action. Living in the world also is an action. Therefore, no reason we learned how to interact with an inert. And in that inert, we were making our mind, we are having this disposition of seeing the reality, the divinity, the God, expressed through that inert stone, inert photograph. And we don't want anything from him. We are just happy to be in contact with him, thinking about him, serving him. And that regular habit of interacting with the divine and seeing the divine in the inert, invoking the divine in the inert, it's a transformation in you, not in the stone. Then when you move around in the world, then everywhere you will have the same disposition. And what to talk about the living beings, human beings, animals, plants, etc. You will serve them even more. You will be even more alert to the life expressing there. This is the practice. So in this way, so you see the step was Vastram Samarpayami, then Upavitam Samarpayami, then jewels was Abharanani Samarpayami, then Tulsi Patram Samarpayami or basil leaves, then scent is you can put Haridra Kunkumam and sandal paste is the Chandanam Samarpayami. Then after that, what is the next one? पाद्यमाचमनीयं च गंधं सुमनसोक्षतान् धूपदीपोपहार्याणि दद्यान्मे श्रद्धयार्चकः. In the 33rd verse he says, the worshipper should then reverentially offer to me water to wash my feet and rinse my mouth with sandal paste flowers and grains of unbroken rice for decoration, incense, light and articles of food. Okay, so all these steps are there. Gudapayasa sarpaipishi shashkulya poopa modakan sanyavada dhisupanscha naivedyam sati kalpayet. So here he is saying, now the next step is in the 34th verse, if there be wealth, one should offer as food to me daily or at least on festive occasions, jaggery, rice boiled in milk and sweetened with sugar, ghee, large and round cakes of ground rice, sugar and sesame seeds and cooked in oil, piles of sweet cakes made of meal and sugar and fried in ghee, lumps of sweets composed of meal cooked in ghee, a kind of porridge made of wheat flour with ghee, milk and molasses, curds and seasoned soup of pulses. Who can offer all these different things? He who has enough money. If you have, do it. Otherwise, patram pushpam phalam toyam. He is happy with just one. Here only he said, if someone offers me just a spoon of water but with devotion, that is enough. And it is not that whole, if you are enjoying it, do it. But majority of the people who do it with such a big extravaganza, they only do it to show off to the world. They only do it, they have a sankalpa. I want to do this puja for the benefit of the world. And they will have all this samagri. And then there will be anyone wants to be a part of it. Okay, $50, $100, $150. And then this Maharaj will do the puja. This puja has to be done for self-purification. Only through self-purification. And what is self-purification of? Of our individuality, of our karma bandhas. As long as those karmas are there, the impressions are there, the desires are there, till then individuality is intact. And by doing this puja, formal worship, in this manner, for no reason, out of joy, out of dedication, without expecting anything in return, brings about the purification in the person. And purification of what? Purification of all those desires. Then when less desires are there, because less impressions are there, if less impressions are there, then the individuality is becoming thinner and thinner and thinner. And when we migrate from the outside puja to mental puja, then it becomes even more finer. Then from mental puja, when we move to japa, it becomes even more finer. From japa, when we transcend the sound, then individuality is dissolved. This is the process. But what we have made it into? We have made it into an act of fulfilling our desires. Please be aware why the Lord is telling all this. Then, in the 35th verse, he says, Abhyangonmardanadarsha danta dhavabhishechanam annadya gita nrutyadi parvani syurutanvaham. He says, offering a brush made of a small green twig with one of its ends crushed for cleansing my teeth, perfumed oil for anointing my body with a paste of saffron and camphor powder for being rubbed on the various parts of my body in order to free it from dirt, bathing my image with a preparation composed of milk, curd, ghee, honey, sugar, as well as with scented water, clothing me with costly silk and adorning me with jewels, sandal paste and wreath, etc., and putting a mirror before me in order to show me how I look, offering me food which could be easily swallowed without mastication, without too much effort, as well as that needing mastication together with fragrant water, betel leaves of a bed of flowers, etc., and also singing songs and dancing, etc., should be arranged at least on a sacred day, example Ekadashi or the full moon, and preferably every day if one's means allow it. See? So all these steps that we showed, all this is the 16 steps. Then after the puja, then havan karo. Ab havan ke baare mein batayenge. Vidhina 36 to 41st. विधिना विहिते कुंडे मेखला गर्त वेदिभिः अग्निमाधाय परितः समूहे पाणिनोदितं परिस्तीर्याथ पर्युक्षेद अन्वाधाय यथा विधि प्रोक्षण्यासाद्य द्रव्याणि प्रोक्षाग्नौ भावयेत माम् तप्त जांबून दप्रख्यम् शंखचक्र गदाम्बुजैः लसत् चतुर्भुजं शान्तं पद्मकिञ्जल्कवाससं स्फुरत् किरीटकटक कटिसूत्रवराङ्गदं श्रीवत्सवक्षसं भ्राजत् कौस्तुभं वनमालिनं ध्यायन्यभ्यर्च्य दारूणि हविषाभिघृतानि च प्रास्याज्य भागावाधारौ वाघारौ दत्वाचाज्य प्लुतं हविः जुहुयान्मूलमन्त्रेण षोडशर्चावदानतः धर्मादिभ्यो यथा न्यायं मन्त्रैः स्विष्टकृतं बुधः. So, depositing fire in a sacrificial pit dug and constructed with due ceremony along with three zone-like constructions, a hollow and a raised ground, one should collect and concentrate it with hand, consecrate it with hand once it has been kindled by fanning it. Means, jo havan hum banate hain, havan ke liye, either you do it with mud or you do it with bricks, and it's a complete science by itself that has not been given here, but he's saying do it with devotion, with sanctity, with hygiene, and do it with hand. And it should be above, it should not be below you. The place where you place the fire, the wood, the samidha, that place has to be higher than where you are sitting. Then that was the 36th verse. Now in the 37th verse, Then enclosing it with all sides with blades of kusha grass, one should sprinkle water on the kusha blades all around, duly replenishing it with fuel while uttering the viharitis, bhurbhuha and so on, and placing to the north of the sacred fire articles to be offered to the fire and sprinkling them with water taken from the consecrating vessel, should contemplate me in the fire as shining brightly like molten gold, distinguished by four arms, resplendent with a conch, discus, mace and lotus, calm and composed, clad in silk, possessing the golden hue of the filaments of a lotus, adorned with a brilliant crown, bangles, a girdle around my waist, kamarband, and excellent armlets, and bearing the marks of Sri Vatsa on my bosom, distinguished with the lustrous Kaustubha gem and with a garland of sylvan flowers. Meaning you are looking at fire, but your attention is on the Narayana or Krishna. Because Krishna only gave the knowledge to the sun, and without the sun, fire is not possible. He is also another expression of the fire only. And fire is the first element from where the form is available. So in that fire, you observe, imagine, you invoke by your mind and your heart this form as Bhagwan has expressed here. This was till 39th verse. Then 40th verse, Dhyayan abhyarcha daruni havishabhi ghrutani cha prasyajya bhaga vagharau adhatva chapya chajya plutam havihi. Then he says, visualizing and worshipping me and casting into the fire sacrificial sticks soaked in ghee, and having made the two offerings of ghee known by the name of agharas, and consisting of sprinkling ghee across the sacrificial pit from the northern to the southern end, and from the southern to the northern end, and uttering the formulas Prajapataye Swaha, Indraya Swaha, and two more offerings known by the name of Ajayabhagas, and consisting of pouring ghee into the sacred fire, uttering the formulas Agnaye Swaha, Somaya Swaha, etc., should offer oblation soaked in ghee, uttering the fundamental mantra Om Namo Narayanaya, and then the hymn known by the name of Purusha Sukta, consisting of 16 mantras, taking a fresh oblation in a limited quantity with every utterance. So the knowing devotee should further offer oblations through the fire to Dharma and others in the order mentioned before in verse 25, uttering the names of the deity with the indeclinable Swaha added to it, and then the oblation known as Swastikruta, which is offered at the end of a sacrifice with the formula Agnaye Swishtakrute Swaha, and is so called because it is believed to turn the sacrifice into a success. So all these, this is just, we are reading it because we are going through everything in Bhagavad. But you want to see it in action? You see Padmini's husband. I don't know if Hanumant is there or not, but Padmini's husband Hanumant, he does the puja whenever we have, many times we have the havan and the pujas, and he does it very systematically without missing any step, you know, with devotion, with love. All these various steps of invoking Agni, how to build the Havan Kund, how to first purify all the ingredients that are there, then using the purified water or the Abhimantrit water, with that, then all the steps that are told, I can't remember everything, all the steps that are told, it requires remembering everything. One mistake, puja is not successful. So people like us, what do they do? Don't do puja. गलती क्यों कर रहे हैं. देन वॉट डू वी डू इफ यू आर अफ्रेड दैट इफ द पूजा शुड नॉट गो रॉन्ग. पर भगवान हिमसेल्फ हैज सेड दैट यू डू ऑल दिस इन डिटेल इफ यू हैव द कैपेसिटी. अदरवाइज मियरली रिमेंबरिंग द लॉर्ड जस्ट बाय हिज नेम एंड ऑफरिंग द वॉटर विद द स्पून इज इनफ. ऑफरिंग द तुलसी इज इनफ. Don't get caught up in unwanted things. Let's continue reading 42nd to 48th verse. Abhyarchath namaskrutya parshadebhyo balim haret moola mantram japet brahma smaran narayanatmakam dattvachamanamuchesham विश्वक्सेनाय कल्पयेत् मुखवासं सुरभिमत् ताम्बूलाद्यमधार्हयेत् उपगायन् गृणन् नृत्यन् कर्माण्यभिनयन् मम मत्कथा श्रावयन् शृण्वन् मुहूर्तं क्षणिको भवेत् स्तवैरुच्चावचैः स्तोत्रैः पौराणैः प्राकृतैरपि स्तुत्वा प्रसीद भगवन् नीति नीति वंदेत दंडवत् शिरो मत् पादयो कृत्वा बाहुभ्यां च परस्परं प्रपन्नं पाहि मामीश भीतं मृत्यु ग्रहणवात् इति शेषां मया दत्तां शिरस्याधाय मसादरं उद्वासये चेद् दुद्वास्यं ज्योतिर्ज्योतिषी तत्पुनः अर्चादिषु यदा यत्र श्रद्धा मां तत्र चार्चयेत् सर्वभूतेष्वात्मनि च सर्वात्मा हमवस्थितः. सो व्हाट इज ही सेइंग हियर इन द 42nd वर्स ही सेज अभ्यर्चयाथ नमस्कृत्य पार्षदेभ्यो बलिम हरेत् मूलमंत्रम जपेत् ब्रह्मास स्मरण नारायणात्मकम् स्मरण नारायण आत्मकम. डोंट मेक हिम इंटू अ सेपरेट बीइंग अपार्ट फ्रॉम द कॉन्शियस सेल्फ दैट यू आर. सो हाउ डू यू रिमेंबर लॉर्ड नारायण एज द सेल्फ विद इन नारायण आत्मकम. स्मरण मीन्स टू रिमेंबर. एनी वे सो वॉट डज ही से हैविंग वर्शिप मी एज ड्वेलिंग इन द फायर एंड सेल्यूटेड मी the votary, meaning the one who is doing the puja and the havan, should offer oblations in the eight directions to my attendants, the Nanda and others mentioned in verse 28 above, and then returning to the place of worship and taking his seat before me, should repeat the moola, principal mantra as long as possible, contemplating all the while on the infinite form of the Lord Narayana. The explanation is not exactly as it is given. Moola mantram japet brahma smaran narayanam atmakam. Narayana atmakam. So atmatvena. Here that is not given in the English. So remember, take the moola mantra, remember the Lord, and remember the Lord as the self within. Then dattvacha manamuchesham vishvaksenaya kalpayet mukhavasam surabhimat tambuladyamatharhayet. Then visualizing me as having finished my dinner, in the meantime he should offer water to me for rinsing my mouth with, and again inviting me back to my seat, should make over the remnants to Vishwaksena, the foremost attendant of the Lord. Again, offering betel leaves, etc., containing aromatic substances intended to perfume the mouth, he should then conclude the worship by showering me with flowers placed in the hollow of once joined palms. Aise karke offer kar do. So, तो प्रसाद की थाली, इन एवरी हाउस वी गिव द प्रसाद थाली टू समवन, नो, तो जिसको देते हैं वो विश्वक्सेन हो गया. विश्वक्सेन इज द फॉरमोस्ट अटेंडेंट ऑफ द लॉर्ड नारायण. तो एनी वे, तो दिस वॉज द, देन इट डजेंट स्टॉप देयर. उसके बाद क्या करना है, देन सेलिब्रेटिंग, रिकाउंटिंग एंड ड्रामेटिकली रिप्रेजेंटिंग माई एक्सप्लॉइट्स, डांसिंग आउट ऑफ जॉय वाइल डूइंग सो एंड नरेटिंग एंड लिसनिंग टू माई स्टोरीज, वन शुड रिमेन इमर्स्ड इन जॉय फॉर सम टाइम. The whole purpose of the puja was not to become miserable at the end of it. Chalo bhai, lambi puja khatam ho gayi, aaj ka din pura ho gaya, meri hazri lag gayi, my attendance, my clock card has been punched. No, it should result in joy. If it is resulting in frustration, next time I am not going to do the puja. Next time I am not going to do the havan. Next time I am not going to take the name of the Lord. In Narad Bhakti Sutra, Bhagavan says, Narad Muni says that the greatest the greatest tapasya is the japa. Japa sadhana is the greatest. So here, when we were in January, February, when we had gone to North India, when we reached our Ayodhya ji, there we were outside a Hanuman temple and a small room was there, and jor shor se Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram, the Sankirtan was going on. And someone had, so some people were there, tabla peti tha, sab kuch chal raha tha. We also went in. And how half an hour went by, we didn't even know. Just got lost in it. Itna anand, chilla chilla ke. Besura nahi. So in the 45th verse, stavai ruchavachai stotrai paurane prakrutai rapi stutva prasida bhagavan niti vandeta dandavata. Glorifying me through long or short hymns found in ancient works such as the Vedas and Puranas, as well as through those composed by human beings, and praying in the words, be pleased, O Lord, he should salute me falling flat on the ground like a log, placing his head at my feet and with his arms joined together at his back after the fashion of a criminal, and saying, O Lord, protect me, afraid as I am of the ocean of worldly existence, rendered all the more fearful by the presence of the alligator in the shape of death, and as such come to you for protection. You can do the namaskar, but don't, if you have a guilt, then go that with this feeling that arms joined together at his back after the fashion of a criminal. Are you a criminal? Are we all criminals? Question. Sab chor ho kya? That which is always available to us, we are not available to him. That which can never be ours, that we are spending our whole life trying to own, collect, have relationship with. Criminal ho gaye. Isi ko Upanishad mein bola gaya, atmahatya, atmahanan. He who does not even once think about that divinity which can never leave him and runs after the world, he is committing suicide on a daily, moment by moment basis. He's killing, the word that is used there is, yes, Atma can never be killed, but he is killing it, this ignorant fellow, by not thinking about it, not accepting it as I. He accepts the world as I. I cannot live without my home. I cannot sleep without my bed. I cannot live without my children. I cannot live without my parents. I cannot live without this. I have to have this in the meal. Agar chutney nahi, achar nahi, toh khana kya khaya? Khak khaya. Nahi, I need everything. Dosa khaya, dosa khaya, chutney nahi banai. Dhar dhur, shuru ho gaya ghar mein. Attention has to be on the conscious principle or the divine within our heart. Then in the 47th verse, he says, Iti shesham maya dattam shirasyadhaya sadaram udvasa cheduhidvasyam jyotir jyotishi tat punaha. Praying thus, he should respectfully place his head as if given by me, the flowers, etc. offered to me, and in case he must send back the deity from the image in the event of its being intended for temporary worship, means he must do the Uttara Puja. Uttara Puja means when you take the sankalp and you invite the Lord, then you are doing Prana Pratishtha, you are inviting the Lord. And Uttar Puja means that you are asking the Lord, requesting the Lord to leave the place. Because if he stays there, then you have to give him morning mein phir Bhagwan ke utne se pehle tumhe utna padega. You'll have to get up before him. You have to do all the puja, 16 step puja. So in temples where pran pratishtha is done, in all the big temples, there it is permanent. There they don't do Uttara Puja. They don't send the Lord back. But when we do our Ram Navami or Krishna Janmashtami, we invite the Lord and we send him back. See? So we invited him to bless us for that particular event. Yes, he is present all the time everywhere, no doubt. But for that particular occasion, we invited him specifically in that particular idol for blessing us. The effulgence invoked into the image should be drawn back from it and merged into the divine flame burning in the lotus of the heart, and the image deposited into some holy tank or river. So visarjan kar do, jaise hum Ganesh ji ka visarjan karte hain ya Durga Mata ka visarjan karte hain. Ganpati bappa morya pudcha varshi laukarya, so we call him next year again. For that we make the idol also, we make it out of mud so that it melts into the water. But what is Lord telling here? Before merging it, before sending him away, take the effulgence, the power of the Lord through the flame, through the fire, the sacrifice that was done, or through the lamp that which is burning there. Take it within your heart. It's all creative visualization. All this is creative visualization. I remember many years ago, some of you were there with me when we went to Maharashtra and we went to Vani Devi. We climbed the mountain and there the goddess was there, and there, after some time, the priest said, okay, you can come, and we couldn't sit in front of the Devi, but there was a side door and we sat there. We could all see the Devi and we started chanting the Lalita Sahasranam. And I also chanted, I also had the booklet, and she was looking. There she is standing like this with your tongue coming out and the mundamalas around her. Ferocious, bhayankar. But it was wonderful to watch. Larger than, she was almost maybe 15 feet tall statue, into the carved into the wall, into the rock of the mountain. And all these ladies and gents, they were chanting the Lalita Sahasranam. I had just done the what do you call the Dhyan mantras of the Lalita Sahasranam, and maybe the first verse or the second verse of the Sahasranam, and my eyes closed. I forced myself to chant, but no, I just got pulled in. And the entire puja, not in that detail, but the entire puja happened within the mind. And it was a young girl who came in the mind. Unreal. So these things happen when we have gone to Kailash. There we have done the havan on the banks of the Mansarovar lake. What was your condition of the mind at that time? When you are walking around, pradakshina kar rahe hain Kailash ki, us samay, so many times, I've been many times, but some of you in different times, some of you have experienced some wonderful, some of them have seen Shiva and Parvati. See? Others see other things. All this is because we have the love within our heart has got invoked. And from devotional point of view, This is the best creative visualization you can ever do in your life to fire your neural networks so that you are always in bliss. You don't need alcohol to get into bliss, to fire your neural networks. This is science. This is not superstition. But people think, hey, isme kya rakha hai? Karke to dekho, in the right frame of mind, phir dekho anand. In the 48th verse, archadishu yada yatra shraddha mam tatra charchayet sarva bhuteshu atmani cha sarvatma aham avasthitah. One can worship me through whichever of the media enumerated in the verse 9 above. Example, an image, he conceives a reverence for on a particular occasion for being the soul of the universe. I dwell in all created beings as well as in the self of the worshipper himself. So there is no fixed. He doesn't say that you have to only invoke Krishna all the time. No. He says, I am alone expressing as all gods. So whether you are praying to Devi, whether you are praying to Lord Shiva, whether you are praying to Hanuman, whether you are praying to Ram, whether you are praying to Skanda, Ganesha, he says, I alone am. So on Ganesh Chaturthi, you will pray to Ganesha. He says, I am only there. And why only talk about the various gods? He is saying, the one who is doing the worship, in the self of that worshipper also I am. Because this is not clicking, therefore we are trying to, this puja is being told. Because why? To purify the karma bandha. And as if it is done in the right manner, then it will be a natural revelation, a natural, yeah, ye to hai. There is no doubt that the self is none other than the Lord. ऐसी condition हो जाएगी. It's like the water is wet. Is this a natural condition? Isn't it? That obvious, once the mind purifies, purification is purification of the desires, means non-eruption of the desires. Once that happens, for that whatever you do is puja only. Then it will be that obvious that that Lord and the Self are not separate. They are one and the same. Or jab ye click ho gaya, uske baad masti shuru. Fir anand hi anand hai. Then such a person can never get depressed. Always inspired. If you are doing puja and getting depressed, then something is wrong in puja. It is only happening because then you are doing puja with something, wanting something in return. That's why the frustration. That's why the depression. Because things are not going the way you want it. Let's read from 51st to 55th verse. Concluding. पूजादीनां प्रवाहार्थं महापर्वस्वधान्वहं क्षेत्रापणसुरग्रामान् दत्त्वा मत्सार्ष्टीतामियात् प्रतिष्ठया सार्वभौमं सद्मनां भुवनत्रयं पूजादीनां ब्रह्मलोकं त्रिभिर्मत्साम्यतामियात् मामेव नैरपेक्ष्येण भक्ति योगेन विन्दति भक्ति योगं सलभत एवं यः पूजयेत माम यः स्वदत्तां परैर्दत्तां हरेत सुरविप्रयोः वृत्तिं स जायते विद्भुग् वर्षाणाम् अयुतायुतं कर्तुश्च सारथेर्हेतोः अनुमोदितुरेव च कर्मणां भागिन प्रेत्य भूयो भूयसि तत्फलम् इजेज पूजादीनां प्रवाहार्थं महापर्वस्वथान्वहं क्षेत्रापुणपुरग्रामान् दत्त्वा मत्सार्ष्टितामियात् वर्शिपिंग मी एज एफोसेड इन अकॉर्डेंस विद द कोर्स ऑफ वर्शिप टॉट इन द वेदास एज ऑल्सो इन द तंत्रा A man secures at my hands success of the kind coveted by him both here and hereafter. So when, remember in Vedas it is given that if the puja is done immaculately, every step is carried out to the T without missing any step, without missing any chanting, without missing the mental disposition, completely focused and dedicated to every step. Bhagwan is telling here that you can achieve anything in this world and the world hereafter, means swarga, etc. And that is the principle. What is the principle? If you are able to bring about a single pointed mind, a focused mind, a concentrated mind, a committed mind, a doubt free mind, I'm giving different options, all of them are the same, a purified mind, nothing is impossible for a person to achieve in life. So whether you do this puja and become This is a very very basic right starting, because कुछ नहीं हो रहा, ये नहीं हो रहा, वो नहीं हो रहा, रोना 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 रोना, चल पूजा कर ले यार. और यू फाइंड योर सेल्फ डूइंग पूजा बिकॉज इट हैज बीन गोइंग ऑन इन योर फैमिली एंड फ्रॉम चाइल्डहुड इट सेल्फ यू हैव बीन इनिशिएटेड इन टू इट. But now change your mindset, change your approach to it. It will help. If you are doing puja at home, it can be merely lighting the lamp every morning. That also is puja. This is the complete detailed one. But what is our attitude? What is our dedication? What is our surrender there? Are we doing it as a chore every day, as a default setting, or are we consciously available at that time when we are lighting the lamp and feeling that may the lamp of light be invoked within my heart also? So when our mind is focused on the divine, and many people are not into all this puja, then what do? They can't remember all the mantras, they can't remember all the steps. It is natural. For many people it is not possible. You do japa. Do japa sadhana. That is also very difficult. Do pranayama. Watch your breath, yaar. Can you do that? That is why it is difficult. Breathing is going on, you are not doing anything. All you have to do is watch. That is also difficult. So this whole process here, it is being told to a devotee who is devoted to the Lord, to the Bhakta, that if he does it in this manner, if he has the resources, he should do it in detail. If not, just mentally also is fine. If he does it in this manner, keeping his focus on the Lord, then there is nothing that he can achieve in this world. It is success in the world is directly proportional to the focus in your mind, single pointedness in your mind. Now if that single pointedness is to kill someone, then you will kill, you will become a murderer. If that single pointedness of mind is employed to pick pockets, now you and me cannot pick pocket with the deftness that a pickpocket does. You won't even come to know that your wallet has vanished from your pocket. That's an art. With single pointedness he has achieved that. See, and practice makes man perfect, they say. But practice, mere practice, no. There has to be dedication, there has to be sincerity. Let it be a tabla master, let it be a dancer, let it be a chanter, let it be a speaker. The more our attention is on the divine who is expressing, it will get better and better. If our attention is on the mind and the mind is absolutely focused, it's not thinking of the divine, but the mind is focused on something in the world, that will also be achieved. But the ingredient that is required for success is single-pointedness. That is the minimum ingredient. And your success out there is directly proportional to the single-pointedness of the mind. And single-pointedness means where you are thinking about one theme to the exclusion of everything else. Here, because you are not able to do it, here the puja is given as an act of purification throughout the puja, or 2-3 hours it will take to do this whole puja. But where is your attention? Your attention is on the Lord. You are in that bhava. You are chanting the mantra, but your attention is on the Lord. You are dressing the statue, but your attention is on the divinity. See? Now you are sitting here for 1.5-2 hours, you will be sitting and listening. Where is your attention? Your focus, hopefully you are focused. That's why you are here. You are all focused for your family. Whatever you are doing in your daily life, going to work, going to sleep, going to waking up, cooking food, driving here, driving there, but your attention is on the family. Single-pointedly, you have fallen into that mode of taking care of your family. It's single-pointedness. It's single-pointedness. I have to take care of my children. I have to cook the food. I have to go social gathering, this, that, everything. But there, that single-pointedness was of the mind. But that mind was not surrendered. You have to decide that. Majority of the people, the mind is not surrendered to the Lord. The ego is functioning. It is my duty. It is my children. It is my responsibility. Same thing can be done. Same activity will go on. But within your heart, the feeling is that it is the Lord's will that is expressing. He is giving the thoughts, he is giving me the energy, he has given me the responsibility, he has come as the kids, he is making the responsibility express itself, the duty express itself. You get out of the way, hand it over to him. Hand it over to him. And if you are not into that, so he has taken different stages here. What is that? Those people who are wanting success in the world, that is why majority of people do the Satyanarayan Puja also. Or they do during the Shravan Mas, they do the Sola Somvar. Why? Because at the end of Sola Somvar, they have already put some wish in front of them. That I'll do this tapasya of chanting the Lord's name for 16 Somvars. And the bucket list is already presented to the Lord. Satyanarayan, we pray to the Lord, we say, if this happens, then I'll do the Satyanarayan Puja. The other way. So you've taken him to task that I will not remember you, I will not do puja of you, I will not do havan for you, I will not do the prasad for you, I will not invite the people. If you want me to do all that, you get my job done. See, this is called inverted thinking. But it's okay. Bhagwan is there for everyone. So somewhere people have to begin. They have to have faith. Somewhere that faith has to be invoked. So once or twice they do it and they say, "Arey, Bhagwan got it done." Then now the love for the Lord gets invoked in their heart. And they experiment with it few times more. Things happen because their mind was focused on the Lord. And as this happens, then they stop desiring, expecting something from the Lord. Now they want to remember the Lord for the Lord's sake, or they want to remember the Lord because they want heavens. They want to go to heaven. Lot of people want to go to heaven. They want the riches. They want to be free of birth and death. They want to be free of hunger and thirst. They want to be in a place where all their desires are fulfilled the moment the desire appears. Wonderful it will be. Because they have not thought about something higher. Okay, do it. Bhagavan says, do it, do the puja. You will get that also. If that is the intention with which you are doing the puja, you are invoking the Lord. So, in the end, then it comes. And as you go there, as your mind, by mistake, by God's grace, by divine providence, you come across a satsang. And in satsang, you hear, "Are yaar, Swarg is only another place. It is not the ultimate joy. The ultimate joy is going to Saket or going to Vaikuntha. How do I do that?" Then your attention is Vaikuntha, 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 Vaikuntha. The more you think about it, then the whole nature then starts presenting that opportunity. The that type of satsangs come, that type of mahatmas come, that type of books come into your life. If you are focused, if the urge to be, to go to Vaikunth is that urgency is there. See? And you have to decide, you want to go right now or you want to go with the last breath. You have to decide. Bhagavan doesn't decide anything for you. You have to decide. So first we wanted something from the world, then we wanted the heavens, then we discarded the heaven also, then we wanted the ultimate jackpot. Go to Vaikunth. And by God's grace, while on this process, you come across Vedanta, then even going to Vaikuntha drops away. Now you don't want to wait to go to Vaikuntha. You want it here and now. Because where the Lord is not, where the divinity is not, it's everywhere. So is it possible? And the moment this type of thinking comes, then we start coming across Jivan Muktas who realize the divinity, who realize the Lord, who realize the Self in this life while living. And that's the ultimate. This is the process. So here, worshipping, so now in the 50th, which verse we are on? Kya ho gaya bhai? English? No, no, the first one was Evam Kriya Yoga Pathaihi Puman Vaidika Tantrikaihi Archan Ubhayatah Siddhim Matto Vindatya Bheepsitam. Ye apne padha nahi. किसी ने बताया भी नहीं मुझे. 49th एंड 50th वर्स वी डिडंट रीड. मदर्चा सम प्रतिष्ठाप्य मंदिरम कारये दृढ़म पुष्पोद्यानानि रम्याणि पूजा यात्रोत्सवाश्रितान. सो विद दिस सो दैट्स व्हाट ही सेड हियर इन द 49th वर्स. वर्शिपिंग मी एज एफोर्सेड इन accordance with the course of worship taught in the Vedas and also in the Tantras, a man secures at my hand success in this world as well as the other world or the higher world. And then in the 50th verse he says, Madarcham sampratishtapya mandiram karaye dridam pushpodhyanani ramyani puja yatrot savashritan. One who can afford to do so should cause a strong enduring, meaning must build a enduring temple, a house for the Lord of worship to be built, and having duly installed my image in it, should further cause beautiful flower garden to be laid out and make a formal grant in favor of the temple, fields, markets, towns, villages, helpful for the daily worship, congregations on sacred days and festivals, granting these for the regular and uninterrupted conduct of worship, etc., from day to day, as well as on specially sacred days, one bids fair to enjoy a fortune as great as mine. What does it mean? That keep the wealth circulating. Don't become a miser. If you have abundance in your life, let that abundance be shared for the higher good. For the higher good. It's not saying just giving it to the temples. It's saying organizing satsangs, holding satsangs, offering prasad. See, in gurdwaras, people do the charity of the prasad. They do the karaseva. They go there, they make the chapatis, they make the dal, they clean the temples, the gurdwaras. Hey, kitni baar bolenge inko yaar? So if we have the resources, we must help people to become devotees of the Lord. See? Somewhere it said, don't give man a fish, teach him how to fish. So just by giving daan, khana wana khilao, no doubt khana khilao. Ashramo mein aap jaoge, if you go to Kumbh Mela, every place, 70, 80, 100 million people ate food in one month there. But you go to any bhandara, there, before you get the food, God's name is taken. When you finish, you cannot get up till the God's name is not taken. See? So then what happens? People who have never taken name of the Lord, at least, are Kumbh mein mile jayenge. Wahan pe, everywhere they go, breakfast they go, they are surrounded by the divine theme. Lunch time, divine theme. Dinner time, divine theme. They are moving around, Mahatmas, they are sitting there chanting the name of the Lord. Some are giving pravachan. And who's organizing all this? It's someone who has the money, who must have donated. That's why it has happened, so that these 70, 100 million people can come together. And their faith in the divine becomes even more dhrid. So we must not be a tool. We must become a tool in the hands of the Lord. Let this body become the vehicle from which the Lord expresses, not the ego expresses. I did not decide that I was going to start speaking. I never in my mind, imagination also, I had ever imagined that I'll be speaking, giving lectures and satsangs. Never in my imagination also. Not even once the thought came to my mind. My only focus used to be to merge into the divine, to contemplate on the divine, to go into samadhi, to keep chanting the name of the Lord. And it kept opening the doors. It kept opening the doors. And now this equipment, this body is utilized only for this purpose. Every day satsang going on. When satsang becomes the diet of the mind, then phir masti masti hai. Kyunki you, if it is not, if not this diet, it will look for something else, because mind wants to interact with something all the time. Adhyatma ne to relative. So either you are thinking about the divine, thinking about the self, contemplating on the self, talking on Upanishads, talking on Puranas, which are reminding us of the essential nature, that is not other than the self, which is divinity itself. If this is not the theme, then the mind will automatically get slip into the world. Again, tu mai shuru ho jayegi wahan pe. Ye tera nahi hai, ye mera hai, ye mera hai, mera hai, tera bhi mera hai. Chalta rahega phir. Me and mine, I and mine. I versus you. See? So that resolve we have to make, that how our life is unfolding in front of our eyes. Is it unfolding in such a manner that it is not ruffling other people, it's not ruffling the society, that this life that is being lived through this body, it is an asset to the society? I'm talking relatively. That is it an asset to the society? Is it an asset to the people who are around? Is it being utilized? Is it becoming a vehicle to further expand its possibilities, meaning the mind's possibilities? And the ultimate possibility is the self alone, or Ishvara, or Krishna, or Narayana, whichever way you put it. Because whether you know it or you don't, you are continuously expanding your potential. From childhood till you got married or till you had a kid, you are expanding only. Even now you are expanding, but the expansion, because we become the doer, become the person responsible for our life, of our wife and husband and children and parents, we feel as if we are under a load, like that Atlas having the whole globe on his shoulders and bending down, you know, carrying the weight of the world on our heads. And then expansion stops, because we have taken on the load of the world. Hand it over to the Lord. And doing this puja, it makes that possible, that you continue your journey of expansion. Whether you know it, if you observe from childhood till now, you have only been, maybe not, as a child you are learning how to speak, how to run, how to walk, how to use a spoon to eat, etc. One, the tables, the year 1, year 2, year 3, etc., etc. But I know some of you, whether you are doctors or engineers or whatever, in which IT, you have to continually upgrade yourself, isn't it? To be relevant in the job, you have to continuously upgrade. The network engineer, someone whom I think Narayan is there, one is at home also. They have to continue. Every year they have to do one or two exams to remain qualified to continue their job. Same thing in life also. Lord must see that this fellow is relevant. He is doing my job. So you have to keep upgrading yourself. The day you stop upgrading yourself, stagnation will set in. And the moment stagnation sets in, no growth, no expansion, less joy, then time to change the body because you did not use it properly. Socho. In the 51st verse he said, puja dinam, puja pravahartham mahaparva, so all that for the special occasions and all, he should be able to share his abundance, share his resources. And resources are not only money and gold and wealth, and someone has organizing capacity, someone has speaking ability, someone has singing ability, someone has dancing ability, see, someone has ideas. So in whichever way you can contribute. In the 52nd verse, pratishthaya sarvabhaumam sadmana bhuvanatrayam puja dina brahma lokam tribhir mat samyatamiyat. He says, through installation of an image, one bids fair to acquire sovereignty on the entire globe. By erecting a temple, he is sure to attain dominion of all the three worlds. Through worship, etc., one can hope to reach the realm of Brahma, and through all these three combined, one can attain a state of equality with me. So what are the three? The first part was told in the 49th verse, then second part was told in the 50th and 51st verse, and the third part is in the 52nd verse. So in this way, what is the ultimate? That you will not be other than the Lord. You will become one with the Lord. That he can have, he has a first secures union. These three, one can attain a state of equality with me. See? Yeah, expansion. When Krishna, you go to, if some of you have come with me to Bali, but you can, if you have been to Bali, you will see every house, every hotel has a temple the moment you enter. Every morning you go, every house and business, on the steps outside or the main door outside, they will have some flowers, one fruit and some incense stick. You go at 6:30 in the morning, entire street is fragrant. Not one street, all the streets. See, when this is told to an ignorant fellow who is struggling in his life, who is a non-believer, so he says, "Acha, I can become one with the, be equal to God. I can get heavens, I can get this, I can get that. I will have the lordship over the world." For that they used to do the Rajasuya Yajna or Ashwamedha Yajna. See? That they became, and by doing that you became the emperor of the world. Bali Maharaj was doing the Ashwamedha Yajna. Not Ashwamedha ke Rajasuya, dono mein se ek kar raha tha koi. Shastri. And then Vaman Avatar, Lord came as Vaman. And when it was told that to Bali, Maharaj, King Bali, he wanted to be established as the next Indra. If he had done that, he would have become the next Indra. There's nothing wrong, anyone can become. But what did he say? That the requirement was that anyone who comes to the kingdom, a yachaka, anyone who comes to the kingdom will be given some dakshina or whatever. So out of arrogance, because he had so much wealth, he said, yes, I will fulfill whatever they want, I will give them. He did not say that I will try to do the best. See, the arrogance came. That's why Lord had to take the avatar of Aman. If he had said, to the best of my ability, I will try to satisfy the needs of whoever comes as a yachak. No, but I will, arrogance, no? That I have conquered the earth, I conquered the mind, now I want to conquer the heaven. Understand that everything that is happening in our life is happening by His grace. It is not happening because we are doing it. When you start seeing His hand in and through every activity, this is the expansion that we are talking about. This is the purification that we are talking about. Then in the 53rd verse he says, Mameva nairapekshena bhakti yogena vindati bhakti yogam salabhata evam yah pujayetamam. He who worships me as aforesaid secures union in thought with me through devotion, and through such course of disinterested devotion one attains to me alone. See, first he says, he who worships me as aforesaid. Namdev Maharaj, he did not do much puja, but he was chanting the name of the Lord continuously. Vitthala, 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 Vitthala. And there he had made Vitthala Bhagwan. Vitthala Bhagwan used to do all his jobs. If anyone came to him, I don't have money, Vitthal Bhagwan, please give him. I am not well, Vitthal Bhagwan, please heal him. And when this happened so many times, then an ego came into him, sattvic ego, that I am the greatest devotee of the Lord. And there, the moment that thought, that feeling came inside him, that became the downfall. There was no downfall for him. But then Jnaneshwar Maharaj, Muktabai, they all came into his life. And now his further expansion was required. This trace of ego needed to be culled out. And then all the Mahatmas of that time, they took it upon themselves by inspiration of the divine only, that how can we help Namdev Maharaj? He is one of us. He is such a great devotee. He sings with so much devotion. He helps the society, the needy. So they were not jealous. They wanted him to get out of this, that I am the greatest devotee, and they hatched a plan. So if we don't lose our ego or dissolve our ego, as told in this manner, or by japa, or by sadhana, or by satsang, then he is hatching plans up there. कि इसको सबक सिखाना पड़ेगा, आई हैव टू टीच हिम अ लेसन, ही इज हैचिंग अ प्लान फॉर अस. Secures union in thought with me. Thought means what? Again, grossified thought is vaikhari. Vaikhari purified is madhyama. Madhyama purified is pashyanti. And when one goes beyond pashyanti, where in Pashyanti, the possibility of duality, that I, the devotee and the Lord, it is still, it's that separation is there, but in unmanifest form. But when we go beyond the Pashyanti, then both the devotee and the devoted, the Lord and the devotee, both become one. The separation is no longer there. So here, when we think of Ram, the statue of the Ram is there and I am here. When I close my eyes, the statue is also in my mind, the thought Ram is also in my mind. Both are thoughts. But when I go beyond Pashyanti, then the duality disappears. That is the topic soon coming up in Amrut Anubhav. Through devotion and through such course of disinterested devotion, one attains to me alone. Disinterested devotion. We don't want anything in return from it. We are loving the Lord for the sake of love. We are not loving the Lord because I want to become one with you. If you have this thought, it will not happen. That union will not take place. Who am I to say it will not take place or it will take place? You make your mistakes and you learn from them. But if we are practicing disinterested devotion, we are not practicing. See, what previous was at thought level. So such people get visions, sub people, Bhagwan comes and appears in front of them. But when it is disinterested devotion, so we are chanting the name of the Lord, but we are not emotional about it. Because we understand. Who is this Ishwara? We know who is this Ishwara. This Ishwara is one without a second. Where is he not? Then I'm not looking for a relationship with him. Then I'm not looking for a vision of him. Then I'm not feeling. When practiced in with disinterest, we have the love, but there is no attachment to the form. Then we land up in the self, the Paramatma, the Brahman. And that is what he is saying, that when with practicing disinterested devotion, one attains to me. That means there is no difference between the Lord and the devotee after that. We are not talking about he also has the Chaturbhuj form. No. He and once the wave merges into the waters, there is no difference between the, there is no identity of the wave left thereafter. Same way, this individual who is taking the name of the Lord with a disinterest, in a disinterested manner, a non-emotional way, then in his life automatically the highest knowledge, now that is the next chapter, when you practice that, the disinterested devotion, what is that? That will be told in the next chapter, the highest truth, the knowledge. then he is not interacting with the Lord, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. No. Then such a student then starts contemplating on the infinity, on the all-pervasiveness, on that Nitya Shuddha Buddha Mukta Tattva. Then automatically that type of books, that is Upanishads, that type of teachers will start coming into his life. You mean to say Adi Shankaracharya was not a devotee who built Kedarnath, who got the Badrinath, Tirupati? All these foundations were laid by Shankaracharya and many, many more. Who wrote Saundarya Lahari, who wrote the Ganga Stotram, Meenakshi Stotram. He is not a devotee. He is talking about Vedanta, no doubt. Vedanta does not mean that you don't have love for the special manifestation of that infinite. Because infinite is all inclusive. Now that's a special condition. You have to raise yourself to it. Yeah, swadattam parairdattam hareta suravai prayoho vrittim sajayate vidbhuk varshanam ayutayutam. He who takes away the endowments made either by himself or by others in favor of the image, a deity or a brahmana, continues for 10 crores of years to be born as a creature living in ordure. Ordure means filth, pig. Creature living in dirt, pig, what do you call those? Kya bolte hain wo? Worms. Who is this person who takes away whatever has been offered to the Lord? If he takes that away, steals it away, because greedy fellows are there, thieves are there, people wanting to misappropriate are always there. So a warning is given that never steal from the Lord. Now that will again be on your attention. Here it is talked about the temple or the deity. If you see this whole universe to be nothing but the expression of the divine, then will you have an idea to possess it? Will you have an idea to steal something from it? Automatically you are sorted once and for all. Vishwamitra wanted to by force take away the Kamadhenu, Surabhikao. By force he wanted to do that. With an ulterior altruistic motive, and the altruistic motive was there is a famine on his in his land and people are dying and there is no rain, and therefore Vasishtha Muni must give the Surabhi cow to Vishwamitra when he was a king. He became Vishwamitra after. He was a Gadhi Nandan. I can't remember his previous name. But what happened to him? That one that I need to possess. This is what we are doing in this world. I need to possess this, I need to possess that, I need to possess this, I need to possess that. Then when we come to the divine, on the spiritual path, then I need to possess this power, this what do you call क्या बोलते हैं, पावर्स को क्या बोलते हैं हिंदी में, सिद्धि, सिद्धि. आई नीड टू प्रोसेस दिस सिद्धि, आई नीड टू प्रोसेस दैट सिद्धि. देयर इज नो एंड टू दिस. वी मस्ट एक्सपैंड, वी प्यूरिफाई टू सी दैट दिस होल यूनिवर्स इज नथिंग बट हिम अलोन. And when this clicks, no, the day it clicks that Ishwara is there and that Ishwara alone created the creation out of himself, so creation is also divine because it is his expression, he created, I didn't create it, then you will stop worrying about the Lord and you will stop worrying about the world. Then you will start working on yourself. That where is my interaction with the Lord and the world going wrong? Because I am also part of this creation. And if the Lord has made this creation out of himself, then I must be also divine. Then why am I not feeling divine? Why am I not feeling divine? Where am I falling short? When this analysis is done, then he will come. But उसके पहले उसको एक लड्डू दिखाना पड़ता है, या like a carrot in front of donkey, then he will do hard work. So this is the carrot that you will get, possess anything in this world, or you will possess anything in the heavens, or you can become one with me. All these are the possibilities that are presented to the seeker or to the devotee. And if you don't, and if you do anything untowards with the deity, with the divine, you steal something from him, then a hellish life is waiting for such a person. The last verse, 55th, kartuscha sarather hetoho अनुमोदितुरेव च कर्मणां भागिनः प्रेत्य भूयो भूयसि तत्फलम्. सच अ डेस्टिनी, वेदर गुड और बैड, एज डिपिक्टेड इन वर्सेस 59-54, अवेट्स हियर आफ्टर द एजेंट एज वेल एज हिज असिस्टेंट, प्रॉम्प्टर एंड सपोर्टर टू, सिंस ईच ऑफ देम इज अ पार्टनर इन द एक्ट. And the reward of punishment is greater according as the action is more dignified or atrocious. So in short, with what intention you are doing all these things from 49th to 54th verse, with what intention are you doing it? With what intention are we performing the puja? With what intention are we organizing the Ram Navami Puja or Krishna Janmashtami Puja? Is it to remember and lose ourselves in the Lord, or is it for collecting donation? Are we remembering the Lord's name? So wherever our attention, that you will get. And nothing, I'm not saying ultimate will be union with the divine, but wherever your attention is or intention is, that alone will fall into your pocket by the grace of the Lord. And the last one that was told was that if you steal from him, you will live life in dirt for how many lives? It was told 10 crore. That means kitna hoga 10 crore? 1 million? 10 million? 1 million? 1 million lives. This is to scare, that don't go the wrong way. Even by thought, don't go the wrong way. Don't wish bad for anyone else. Don't misappropriate. Don't be jealous. Don't be envious. Don't be angry. Be content with what Lord has provided. Be content with what Lord has provided. And in this way, इति श्रीमद्भागवते महापुराणे पारमहंस्यां संहितायां एकादशस्कंधे सप्तविंशोऽध्यायः. Thus ends the 27th discourse in book 11 of the great and glorious Bhagavat Mahapuran, otherwise known as the Paramahamsa Samhita. Now, I think we'll conclude. Now the next chapter, 28th chapter, is the highest truth discussed. So there, when he said, with disinterested devotion one attains to me alone, what is this? He is not mentioning that particular word line, but I am thinking that, because that will be the ultimate. So that will be the highest truth. How to bring about the union? How to recognize that the self that we are is essentially divine? We are considering ourselves to be the Jivatma, but actually we are nothing but the divine. How to get to that probably will be the topic. I don't know, I'm just thinking loudly. So we will see that in our next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.